throwing papers!
Sound like that new bounce.
By the way, H-U-E-Y.
Boy, M-Hit,
yep. Partner. Ho-Ho, you a fool for this one.
Toot that thing up, mommy, make it roll. Once you pop, pop, lock it for me, girl, get low. If your mama gave it to your baby girl, let it show. Once you pop, pop, drop it for me, maybe we can roll. Oh!
Pop, lock, and drop it. 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 Pop, lock, and drop it.
Tonight it's gonna be some changes, no actions to dig it. So stop acting and get it clapping, cause I'm knowing you feel me. Yeah, you cute, but don't let this shit go to your head. Cause what this beauty won't do, pimping another one will. You prefer rocking the suit, and your heels so tall. And we ain't with none of that tricking, but I feel so tall. I've been peeping you for a while, and you throwing it back. If you looking for you a baller, we got dough in the back. Look, your color called yellow brown, and your skin so smooth. I'm having fantasies about what you and me can do. And you an undercover freak, you probably thinking the same. I'm saying light up on your face, pressure deep in my chain. And
Lewis, rapper dies in an overnight shooting. It happened in Kinloch.
It's rapper Huey, whose real name is Lawrence Franks Jr. That shooting happened just before 11 last night. It was on Martin Luther King Boulevard near Maple Avenue. St. Louis County Police are investigating, but there's no word yet on any arrests. Huey is best known for his 2006 debut single, Pop, Lock, and Drop It. Rapper Huey was 31 years old.
Yo, 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 what's up, everybody? Simple 2. Okay, brand new video for this Thursday month for y'all, man. I'm gonna do for y'all. Okay, I'm popping them ladies on Why I'm Too Rapper Suits, because my channel. Okay, the video I'm talking about the late rapper Huey, man, on okay, Huey was a rapper from St. Louis, and how he's, you know, to what he know about a song called Pop, Lock, and Drop It, and how he's a rapper from the city, man, to where he's getting killed back around in 2020. I say it's a neighborhood, so he's trying to kill either. And because if you know, you know, talk about his life as a rapper and his own career and his death, man. So here you go, man. Okay, Huey, you know, I said about his own, I think his name is on Lawrence Franks Jr., how his dude from St. Louis. So he born in he's from this, let me see, in a city called Kinloch, Missouri. So he was raised in the type of family, man. So his own family had, you know, was part of the music scene. So I think he, yeah, we're somewhere until he moved to the type of neighborhood called Warner Park neighborhood, you know, St. Louis, when he was 5 years old. You know, he turned to, I think St. Louis County area, you know. And so I think I read somewhere they were growing up in the hood, to his family and his, you know, like his brother was, you know, I think I got a lot of stuff in the hood, to where brother, you know, when, you know, I think went to jail and how he had, you know, grew up in type of environment to where, you know, so a lot of drugs and violence going on in our neighborhood. So yeah, they started like up doing music when he probably around 14 years old. So we started rapping, I think it was brother, how he had, you know, created it's a type of rap group of time, So I think he put out his first album called Notebook Paper back around 2006, and how to where he made his first debut album, and how he, and so I think his single was called Pop, Lock, and Drop It, and how the song, you know, I said Kevin Renault, I said throughout the whole city, I said Louis and the whole country, man. But so I think he put out a film tape called Unsigned Hype, you know, how he put out like a couple music out of the past, and how he's a rapper had made come up in the music game. So he had like, you know, this thing, and how he made up his first his single. I said the single had peaked at number 6 on the Billboard High 100 chart, and how his biggest, you know, rapper at the time. And I said in the mid 2000s how he'd be a rapper at the time, how he grew up, you know, doing music. And okay, they put out his I think his second album called Redemption. You know, I said around the year 2010. So I think he put out his first single called Smile and Wave, you know, featuring the rapper with a role, you know, back around June 5th, 2010. And so, let me see. I think he put out his third album called Project H. So, yeah, recently when he had, like, a song with, song with Waka Flocka Flame, label called Brick Squad, made his first third album or something. So, I think he put out his third album called Project H back around May 14th. May 14th, 2014. And so, let me see. I think it's part of his, started off into doing a lot of projects and stuff in the past. I think Riley died, you know. And so, I think he put out like a mixtape in the past called Who the F is Harry and Project H, you know. So, I do feel like his own career, you know, kind of went, you know, up and down over the years. So, I think that he's a type of, I Want Him Wonder, because he made one song that's popular, you know, the city from. So I feel like the song, Polly and Droppy, is the type of song, I know that he made, and how he's a dude that kind of had, you know, stopped doing songs at the time. I think he was a dude that was, you know, focused on, I think, on his own business, like something like that he made. And so I feel like he made business. I think he started doing his own, you know. I think the company at the time. So I think he's doing his own business. It's type of upscale business. To where he did his own, you know, own, I think, clothing line for shoes, clothes, and pants and shirts and stuff he do on the side. But he still. I still doing music and doing his thing, his business, and Tragic Day, man, around June 25th, 2020. So it said Frank's an unidentified 21-year-old man, companion were shot in front of Frank's home back around 2020, to where, you know, he was in his home, outside his home, to where somebody shot both of them in Cone Lodge, Missouri area. He said, both men were hospitalized, but following day, French died from his wounds. So, man, I said, 113 years old, you know, he died, so he got shot and killed, man, you know, on time from. But I do feel the rivalry, if he shot and killed, you know, on time from, it'd be over jealousy and hate, man. But if I do, he got shot and killed, man, by his own city, man. But, so I do feel like the rivalry, who can kill, is about over anything, be over money, hate. How the, you know, Robert Huger had died, man, until he got shot 4 years ago, you know, his own hood, man. But, and but I feel like Robert Sue, who made it, you know, it's sometimes they had to move out of hometown in front of him due to like hate going on. But Huger had stayed in his own town until he focused on, I guess, you know, his own career, man. But I don't know, I feel like his own career had short lived at the time, so he had, you know, made his thing, music, you know, till he had, you know, either to where he had died. But, so I passed out peace to Huey, man. So make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. To peace. I'm out here. Take care. Peace.